Hello everyone and welcome to Usability. Today we are going to see how to easily install and play The Walking Dead No Man's Land on our PC. It's an Android game. Let's see how to install it thanks to BlueStacks. You're watching it on the screen right now. Without further ado, let's get to it. Here we are. First, let's open our favorite browser, in our case Google Chrome. You use the one you like the most. The next thing to do is copy the URL. There is the URL, I put it a little bit bigger on the screen. You don't have to type anything or anything like that. In the comment box and in the description, you have the URL to click on. You type enter or click, and here you go to this very well set up, very simple web page, where we see here the game The Walking Dead No Man's Land, that we can download and play in PC. They tell you a little bit about what the game is about, the advantages you have of playing with BlueStacks. For those who don't know, it's an Android emulator, it's as if you had a mobile phone or a tablet on your PC. Let's click on this cute, beautiful, big button and download The Walking Dead No Man's Land. It starts downloading. Now we have downloaded, let's click on it. The installer opens. Windows is going to ask us for permission. You say yes, that you trust the application. We say yes and the installer is launched. Here it is, The Walking Dead No Man's Land. The PC game installer. We have here this tick that you have to accept it, accept the software license. We mark it, and the rest serves to customize the installation. If we click it, it allows us to change the directory where we are going to install the emulator. We go back by clicking on the back button and click on install now. Now we are going to download BlueStacks, the PC emulator. Once downloaded, it will proceed with the installation. While this extracts the files and installs them, depending on your PC, it will go faster or slower. I'm going to cut, wait for it to finish, and come back soon. It's already installed, it just finished, and now the emulator runs automatically. This is the Android emulator. Before we start, BlueStacks will do a series of installations and configurations because it is the first time we run it. It takes between 2 and 3 minutes, but depending on the PC, it may take less than 2 minutes or more than 3 minutes. It just finished, and the next step is essential, you have to log into Google Play. If you don't have a Google Play account, create one, but you have to log into Google Play. Otherwise, it doesn't work. Let's sign in. We'll sign in again, and here you'll be asked for our username, our email or phone number, and our password. I'm going to fill in the data, and when I'm done, we'll come back. Filled in data, and here it asks us to accept Google's terms of service. We agree, we accept them, and that's it. Now it tells us if we want to make a backup on the Google Drive of the device. I'm going to tell it no, you guys do what you want. In my case it's not necessary, if you want a backup, go ahead. We accept, now it takes us to Google Play. We'll exit it if it doesn't exit automatically. There are times when it exits automatically. We have to go here. What this button does is it goes to the desktop of the emulated mobile device. We click it, and the Walking Dead icon appears. Before I click on it, I'm going to translate the language of the emulator. Super fast, it doesn't take 30 seconds. In the icon of the gear wheel, settings, we click. We click again on settings. In settings, we will go to preferences, click. We have the drop down menu, we select the language we want. We close, and as you can see, it's already translated. Now click on the icon of The Walking Dead No Man's Land and install. One last step, to complete the account setup. It will tell us to complete the installation and fill in one of these options. Payment method, we are not going to make any payment, so we are going to click on skip. We skip, and this way, we start to install the game. If you want to enter some payment method, enter it, but it's not necessary. The game will start downloading 323 megabytes, depending on your internet speed, it will be more or less fast. As soon as it finishes downloading, it will start the installation. There it is installing, it shouldn't take long. It has already been installed. It says here at the bottom right that BlueStacks The Walking Dead has been installed. Simply press open, and the game opens. It says it needs to read and write permission from the external storage, we accept. Access to the photos, press allow, we allow all access he asks for, and that's it, the game is launched. Here we go, we accept the privacy policy and start loading. I'll tell you a couple of things while it loads. We have three icons installed here, the BlueStacks 1 to launch the emulator, the Walking Dead 1 to start the game directly. We run the one we want. A couple of things, if you want to change the controls, click on this icon here, it launches the keyboard configuration. One last thing is how to put the game in full screen. You have to click on this full screen icon and the game will be 100% full screen, taking up the whole desktop. We are going to let it load. As you can see, it's full screen. To exit the game, you have to hit F11, click on F11, and you will exit in full screen mode. That should do it. Super easy, simple, you know. All the links are in the description and the comment box. Anything you want, leave it in the comments box. If you like it, give it to like and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next videos. Bye.